Welcome to Maple Dean's Blue Planet, where we'll tell you all about the oceans of the world.
Why are you talking about the oceans? We live in Sheldon, the nearest ocean is miles away.
Well, if you listen, you will realise that oceans are important to all of us wherever we live.
That is true. They are as important as the tropical rainforests.
You see, oceans cover over 70% of the Earth.
And it's not just the vast surface of the ocean. We are talking about the mysterious oceans are deeper than the height of
the
crust.
The ocean is so deep that scientists have had to split it into four separate layers or zones.
At the surface, we have the sunlight zone, which is where over 90% of the living creatures in the ocean is actually living.
This is where we find playful dolphins and speedy seals.
It's also where you find the most feared sea creature in the world, the great white shark.
Great white sharks live in nearly every ocean.
And they might eat you.
They are apex predators. They eat sea mammals like sea lions and seals.
They look really scary, but they hardly don't attack humans.
In fact, more people get killed each year by toilets, and you aren't scared of going to the toilet, are you?
The sunlight zone is the only zone where we find producers.
Producers are plants like seaweed, seagrass and algae. They make their own food from sunlight.
Producers are at the start of every food chain.
The sea is full of amazing food chains because there are so many carnivores.
Carnivores are animals who eat other animals.
And the animals they eat are called plants. Some animals eat meat and greenery. We call them omnivores.
When an animal only eats greenery, it's called herbivore, just like this mountain.
Herbivores are usually hunted by predators.
In the sunlight zone, there are lots of predators and lots of prey. It is full of creatures and it is very light, as its name suggests.
The sunlight zone is where people enjoy swimming, diving and playing, just like dolphins.
The next zone, however, is rarely visited by humans.
You would need special equipment to dive down into the twilight zone.
It is much darker down here in this zone, so no producers live here.
In fact, most of the creatures that live here are fast moving to catch their dinner, and there are no herbivores.
It is not as dark in the twilight zone as it is in the next zone, the midnight zone.
The midnight zone has no light, it is pitch black.
Animals in this zone have to make their own light.
Some creatures, like the anglerfish, make their own light to attract their prey to swim right into their mouths.
Deeper still, the next zone is the abyss. The creatures down here often have no eyes at all, and they scavenge on the sea floor for no food. But this is not the deepest part of the ocean. The deepest parts are called the trenches, and the deepest part of these is the Challenger Deep.
Challenger Deep is about 36,000 feet deep. That is about the same height that an aeroplane flies when going to another country.
Before this water, as you can imagine, there are billions of living things in our ocean.
Some of these living things are capable of creating oxygen. It is believed that over half of the world's oxygen comes from these ocean plants and creatures Our oceans are really amazing.
The oceans are also home to some amazing places,
including many beautiful islands like these.
On Friday nights, it's possible we might be eating plastic and chips.
What can you do to save the ocean?
Well, first off, we can try not to use single-use plastic, like shopping bags and plastic water bottles. Reduce, reuse, recycle.
We can also try to use less electricity and use our cars less to drive around.
Finally, we can tell other people what we have learned. Please spread the word and help us to save the ocean.
What a about sunrise? What about rain? What about all the things that you said we were to gain? What about killing feels? Is there a time? What about all the things that you said was yours and mine? Did you ever stop to notice all the blood we've shed before? Did you ever stop to notice this crying earth, this weeping shore?
I don't know.